Good morning, student. Hope you all are fine and healthy. In chapter number 7, we have completed up to question number 12 from your workbook. Today, we will start the question number 13, that is an experiment. In science, when we have to prove something, hame koi bhi cheez ko prove karna hota hai in a systematic manner, usse hum bolte experiment. Okay? First, I will explain you how to write an experiment. When you will write an experiment, you have to cover all these 6 points. The first point is aim. Aim means what you have to do. Tumhe kya karna hai, wo tum kis mein likhoge? Aim mein. Then next point is apparatus required. Ab tumhe experiment karne mein kaun kaun si cheezon ki need hai, you will write in a apparatus required. Then figure. जो भी तुम किस तरीके से सारे अपने apparatus को अरेंज कर रहे हो, यू हैव टू ड्रॉ इन अ फिगर. ओके, देन इज प्रोसीड्योर. प्रोसीड्योर में तुमने एक फर्स्ट क्या स्टेप किया, सेकंड कौन सा स्टेप किया, वो सारे स्टेप्स यू विल राइट इन अ प्रोसीड्योर. नेक्स्ट इज ऑब्जर्वेशन. इन ऑब्जर्वेशन व्हाट, व्हेन यू हैव कंप्लीटेड देन एक्सपेरिमेंट, व्हाट यू ऑब्जर्व, तुमने क्या ऑब्जर्व किया, यू विल राइट इन ऑब्जर्वेशन. एंड लास्ट इज कंक्लूजन. आप इतना एक्सपेरिमेंट करने के बाद तुम कंक्लूड करोगे, यस, जो तुम्हारा एम था वो तुमने प्रूव कर दिया. सो व्हेन यू विल राइट एन एक्सपेरिमेंट, यू कवर ऑल द 6 पॉइंट्स एंड ऑर्डर ऑफ दिस पॉइंट्स विल बी सेम. यू विल नॉट चेंज एनी ऑर्डर. अगर तुम पहले प्रोसीड्योर और फिर बाद में फिगर ड्रॉ करते, योर एक्सपेरिमेंट विल कंसिडर एज अ रॉ. क्लियर? तुम्हें यही पैटर्न फॉलो करना है तुम जब भी एक्सपेरिमेंट लिखोगे. एक्सपेरिमेंट इज ऑलवेज ऑफ 5 मार्क्स. एक्सपेरिमेंट 5 मार्क्स का आता है एंड यू हैव टू कवर ऑल द 6. So let's start our first experiment. Describe with the help of an experiment that stems conduct water and dissolved minerals from the roots to other parts of a plant. Here, your aim is to prove that stem conduct water and minerals. Stems water or minerals लेती है roots से और उसे other parts of a plant तक पहुंचाने का काम करती है. This is your aim. To prove this aim, what the apparatus you require. So the apparatus required herb. There should be herb without roots. Glass tumbler. This is a glass tumbler. You can see here, this is your glass tumbler. Water and the red ink. If you want to take any other ink, you can take blue, orange, any color ink, you can take it. This is your figure. You have to arrange this apparatus in this format. This is your glass tumbler. In a glass, you will put the herb, which is without root. Then in a glass, you will put water and any color ink. Here, I have taken the red ink. Okay. Now the procedure. So first is fill the 1/3 glass with water. पहले glass को water से भर दो, 1/3, not full glass. Add few drops of red ink in the water. कुछ drops ink ही डालो. Then cut the base of the stem of a herb. See in this picture, this is your stem. You have to cut this part. Okay. Then put it in the glass containing red water and observe the different parts of a plant next day. अब तुम्हें वो जो plant के जो different parts हैं वो तुम्हें कब observe करने? Next day. So what you will, what the observation? Observation is the stem and the branches of the herbs turn red. Stems और जितनी भी branches हैं herb की, वो किस में कौन से color में change जाएंगी? Red color में. Why? Because we have given a red color water to the stems. और जैसा water हम stems को देंगे, वो वैसा का वैसा ही parts, other parts of plants तक पहुंचाएगा. So what we will conclude, hence we can say that stems conduct water and dissolve minerals from the roots to other part of a
beaker with some water and put a few drops of red ink in it. Take a tender twig with leaves and white flowers and keep it in the beaker for 8 to 10 hours. After 8 to 10 hours, you observe red colored lines through the stem, leaves and flowers. It indicates that water moves up through the stem. But how does water reach other parts?
Now, the second experiment. In second experiment, you have to prove that plants give off water in a form of water vapor in the process of transpiration. Here you have to prove that leaves undergo the transpiration process. In video, I've already explained what is transpiration. So transpiration means the leaves release the water from stomata. That process is known as transpiration. So here you have to prove that plants give off water in the form of water vapor in the process of transpiration. So the apparatus you required for this experiment is potted plant. This is a potted plant, transparent polythene bag and a string. Here you have to arrange in this matter. You have to take the potted plant, then take one branch, cover it with the polythene bag, transparent polythene bag, and tie its mouth with a string. So what is the procedure? First of all, take a potted plant, then enclose a leafy branch of a plant. You must care that the branch which you are covering, it must be a leafy. It is full of leaves. In a polythene bag and tie up its mouth with a string. Now let the pot remain under the sun for a sometime. Now keep that pot under the sun for a sometime. And then observe the inner surface of a bag after some hours. You have to observe the inner surface of polythene. So what you will observe that water droplets are observed on the inner surface of the polythene bags. The inner surface is covered is full of water droplets. So hence we can say that plants give off water in the form of water vapor in the process of transpiration. It means that leaves undergo the transpiration process.
Take a medium-sized potted plant. Cover it with a polythene bag and tie its mouth at the base of the stem with thread. Mark this polythene bag A. Next to the potted plant, place an empty polythene bag and tie the mouth with a thread. Mark this polythene bag B. Expose this setup to the sunlight for an hour. After an hour, you will see that drops appear inside the polythene bag A. The polythene bag B does not show any water droplets in it. From this, we conclude that the leaves give out water vapors. Due to condensation of the water vapors, tiny drops of water get collected inside the polythene bag A. This experiment shows that plants give out water to the atmosphere through transpiration.
Now the last experiment, third experiment, with the help of an experiment prove that leaves of a green plant contain starch. We have already do the experiment of starch. So when we will put any substance iodine solution, if the color changes from blue or black, then we will say that in that substance starch is present. Here you have to prove that in leaves the starch is present or not. So we will prove that leaves of green plant contain starch. To do this experiment, the apparatus we required are test tube. This is a test tube. Then this is a beaker. Spirit. Spirit is a chemical which you only get in the laboratory. So in this experiment, we will not perform at our home. This experiment is only performed in the laboratories. Okay. Then water, green leaf. This is a burner. This is a tripod stand, iodine solution, and a glass piece. You can see this is a glass piece. So what is the procedure? First, take a leaf in the test tube. Test tube mein leaf lo and pour spirit to completely immerse the leaf. Itna spirit lena, itna chemical lena hai ki tumhari leaf puri uspe test tube mein doob jaye. Now place the test tube in a beaker half filled with water. See in this picture that you have to put this test tube in a beaker in this manner. Now heat the beaker till all the green color from the leaves come out from this into the spirit in the test tube. You have to heat the beaker till the green color of leaves disappear. Okay, now take out the leaf carefully and wash it with the water. Leaves में से वो leaf निकालो और उसको wash करो अच्छे से. Now place it in on a glass, it on a watch glass and pour some iodine solution over it. फिर उस leaves में कुछ iodine solution डालो. Then observe the leaf carefully. The color of leaves turns into the blue or black. अब उस color का leaf का color किस में convert हो जाएगा? Blue or black. And we know that whenever the color of any substance changes to blue or black, it means the in that substance the starch is present. So hence we can say that the green leaves of green plant contains.
First, we have to take a leaf from a plant. Then take a beaker with water. Now take a test tube and pour methylated spirit into it. Insert the leaf into the test tube such that leaf should be immersed in the methylated spirit. Boil the leaf in methylated spirit over a water bath till it becomes pale white. Carefully take the leaf from test tube and place it in a petri dish. Observe here, spirit becomes pale green due to chlorophyll dissolved in it from the leaf. Leaf becomes pale white due to the removal of chlorophyll from it. Add a drop of iodine solution on the leaf. Observe carefully. Is there any color change in the leaf? Yes, the leaf turns into blue-black color. Why does it occur? Already we know that iodine solution is the starch indicator. Starch gives blue-black color in the presence of iodine solution. So that this color change indicates that starch is present in the leaf.